Hello everybody, this is going to be a video kind of like killing two birds with one stone, because I can start my SDEX standard Strike Exia custom, and I can show off the compatibility between the different kits in the line, and how easy it is. I haven't actually done anything yet, I haven't tried it, but I figured this would be a good time to do it. I still haven't done anything else with my old version of Strike Exia. He's holding his horns right now. It's been crappy weather. I had literally 2 hours I could paint, and I did it with something else, which I'll probably show in another video. So let's get going. So if we're going by the other one I have, now I prefer to have the arms of the Exia compared to the Strike Freedom if I can get away with it, and I can get away with this one. But I want to keep the shoulder armor, so that shouldn't be too hard to do. So just buck. You can keep the ball joint. I don't need that. So, come on. Like I've said before, these are actually really good ball joints. Surprise, surprise. There we go. So we'll get rid of that, and we'll get the shoulders. Alright, now we'll give them to Exia. You can keep the ball joints. So, come on. Yeah, there we go. So, go like that. And take the arm and dig it in. Holy tight, jeez. Well, they're not falling out, that's for sure. So, there we go. There's one done. And here's the other. Alright. And, oh no, I need the ball joint. Please give me that back. Please and thank you. That would be nice, thank you. Alright, so there are the arms attached. Now, I like to keep the legs and the feet. I couldn't keep them with the other version I have because the waist is made for the legs of the Exia, because I had to use Strike Freedom's waist, so, but I want to use Strike Freedom's waist. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna decapitate you. And once again, these ball joints are like the best ball joints I've ever seen. It is weird. Alright, so. Oh, you're gonna need that. Yeah. I probably should have taken this apart before the video, but, well, what's done is done. Ooh, that doesn't sound good. Yeah. I think everything's okay. Whoops. Whoop. There we go. Guess it wasn't pushed in all the way. Let's try that again. Hey. Kevin. Alright, there. I think it's in. So, we got that. And giving Exia its waist again, its ball joint. Alright. I just gotta plug it in. And then, the final touch is the backpack. Now this is the easiest, I hope. I'm assuming it should be the easiest. But now I'm not really sure, not looking at the, looking at this, it might not be as easy as I was hoping. Because the backpack, this is like the only kit that is different in the back, I just realized that. Because, actually let me just bring in, bring the R70 too, because I'm pretty sure it'll work. Yeah. So you can easily do that. But Exia, because of the GN drive, is a little different. I wasn't even thinking about that. I could probably get away with just, actually, if I cut these pegs off and just take a simple peg from an extra, like, part from a plate and stick it in here, and then stick it in that hole there, the rectangular hole, and it would probably work perfectly fine. And I think that would work. So, not 100% compatible with some kits, but I mean, let's bring in the L-Strike. See, it has one peg, so some ones do, some... This might actually work. Could this work? Not quite. But would this work? There we go. Strike with a G and dry. Zoom. Alright, so... I have learned something today. That not everything is going to be compatible. At least the backpack. The limbs are fine. The body's fine. But the backpack, not 100%. But like I said, I can easily fix that. I had to do it with the original SD here, where I just glued on his backpack onto the GM drive itself. So, I mean, it's not a big deal. But this is more as what I want compared to this one. I still have to fill in that spot there, but this is the way I want it. This is what I want. I might add some more panel lines on these shoulders. I mentioned that it's very panel line heavy here, but not here. And compared to the arms as well now. So, yeah. This is what you can do, and I'm definitely looking forward to using this one. This one, not as excited. I'll probably still do it, but I think this is my priority now. I just need to buy... I want actually another Exia and Strike Freedom, because I want to have them by themselves and paint them separately. And then have my Strike Exia. And eventually, it'll happen. So, yeah, just thought I'd show that. So now you know that everything is compatible. Mostly just the backpack. Some are, some aren't. And, yeah. So, if it ever is nice out, who knows. Tomorrow, like, as of this recording, we're supposed to get, like, freezing rain tomorrow. God. Oh, well. But that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.